Smith Lilly. I'm a professional trainer of American Saddlebred show horses, and I wrote a book called Saddle Seat Horsemanship. Today I want to talk about a subject that's near and dear to my heart, and that's riding as an athlete. And as we all know, any sport that we play, we have to have the right equipment. And I think this is the right equipment. The Freedman World Cup Super Grip Saddle is the best saddle for me. It's the best saddle for our riders. It helps them ride as an athlete. So about 15 years ago, David Freedman came to me and I was riding a different brand of saddle. And he said, just take this saddle home and try it. And I was skeptical because I like my saddle. But I took it and tried it, just mainly as a favor to David. I got in the saddle and I rode it for about 10 seconds. And I knew it was a better piece of equipment. It gave me more stability as a rider, it gave me better feel of the horse as a rider, and it was a more solid piece of equipment underneath me. I loved it from the very minute I first sat on it, and it's helped me become a better rider and a better athlete in the saddle. Not only is this saddle the best piece of equipment for a rider, it's the most comfortable saddle I've ever put on a horse's back as well. My horses love it, they feel great in it, they move well underneath it. It's the best piece of equipment I can find for them as well. So now that we've talked about the right tool for the job, let's talk about the athletic ready position and how to ride as an athlete. So any sport you play, I don't care if you're a downhill skier, you play soccer, you're a goalie, you play volleyball, basketball, whatever it is, you have to have your balance over your feet and you have to be in the athletic ready position, okay? So that means knees bent, ready to move, balance over your feet. And it's the same as a rider. So this is Kayla Vogel. She's one of our riders at Mercer Springs Farm, and she's going to demonstrate for you today what we're talking about with these concepts. So Kayla, let's get in the athletic ready position. Let's get in the power position with your hands as a rider. If I were to be a magician and I could magically make this horse disappear from underneath Kayla, she should land on her feet totally in balance. Now there's two faults that riders have. They either have a fork seat or a chair seat, and all of us are inclined to be one way or the other, either towards a fork seat or towards a chair seat. I'm personally inclined towards a fork seat. You see a lot of riders inclined towards a chair seat. Kayla herself is more inclined towards a fork seat. So let's show what a fork seat looks like, Kayla. That's when you get a little farther forward, you lean a little forward, you see how her leg has come back on the saddle, okay? So her leg is not gonna be able to influence the horse because it's too far back, and she's out of balance if the horse, she's in front of the motion of the horse and her posture's not good. All right, let's show what a chair seat looks like. All right, so a chair seat, even just to exaggerate that just a little bit more, right? When you sit back too far on the back of your seat, you're too far on the back of the saddle, but see how her legs come forward now and she really can't use her leg to help influence and help ride that horse, all right? So now let's get in your strong, correct, athletic ready position, and let's go ahead. I'm gonna be the horse now, and let's see how strong Kayla can be. And see how that, she's light in her hands, but she's strong in her body because she's in balance. She has balance over her feet. And I can't really pull Kayla out of position because she's strong through her back, through her seat, all the way down her leg. Now let's get in your fork seat and see what happens. See how easy it is? I don't have to pull at all, okay? You're not strong and your horse feels that. Let's get in your chair seat. And the horse leaves and what happens? You're caught behind the motion and your feet kick forward, okay? So you don't have balance that way either. How do we fix all that? How do we adapt to that as a rider? Well, a lot of it has to do with your stirrup bars, and these saddles are great for that. So the more you're inclined towards a fork seat, the more your leg wants to kick back, the more you want to have that stirrup bar further forward, one of the first two hole adjustments. Conversely, if you want to have the chair seat naturally and you find your leg always too far forward, you want to have the stirrup bar further back in one of the back two holes so that will help counteract your natural tendency, help put you in the right place. And the best way to do that is practice, practice, practice. You just have to get in the saddle and ride. So in my book, we talk a lot about the independent seat and how critical that is to be a good rider, is to have an independent seat. And Kayla has learned to do that. She does a great job showing our horses, showing our young horses, but it's important for any rider. What is an independent seat? It means you can operate your bridle without holding on for balance. Because if you're holding on to the horse's mouth for balance with your hands, you're teaching them to tune out from the bridle. Likewise, the same thing with the leg. You see so many riders with the fault of gripping with their calves all the time or even posting off their calves. Well, how are you going to use your calves to bend the horse, to send the horse forward, if you've taught your horse to tune out by gripping with your calves all the time? So we need an independent seat, means you can sit deeply and you can remain in balance without using your hands or your lower legs for balance and control. And it's so important to use your three physical aids, your hands, your seat, and your legs, all in concert, and you can only do that if you learn to have an independent seat, which takes a lot of riding and a lot of practice, but it pays big dividends. So above all, remember, We're all growing as riders. We're all hoping to get better. We're all working towards perfection, but we know we can't quite get there. But you need the best equipment you can find. The World Cup saddle from Freedman's is the best equipment you can find for this. Good luck as you help develop your athletic potential as a rider and your independent seat and your partnership with your horse.